Hello and welcome back to Manna from Devon Cooking School in South Devon. I'm David Jones and today we're going to be making pitta breads. Hopefully you've seen some of our earlier videos where we made this simple, beautiful Mediterranean dough with a little bit of yogurt in it. And we've been making various breads with that already. We made a lavash from the Lebanon or from the Middle East. We made a manish from the Lebanon. And today we're going to be making a pitta bread, which is found all over the kind of Eastern Mediterranean, particularly kind of Greece and Turkey. You'd find that nice pocket in it, ready to be stuffed full of something beautiful, some nice spiced lamb or some chicken or hummus or something like that. So here's a dough I made earlier. And the recipe for this you can find in video number one of this series. And I just want a couple of pieces off this to make our pitta bread. And it's just this wonderful versatile dough that I can do all sorts of things with. For a pitta bread, I want about 100 grams. And we're just going to make a couple of those, just for demonstration purposes. And these are fantastically easy to make. People kind of think it must be really difficult to make a pitta bread because you've got to get that pocket inside it somewhere. But actually, it's not. Very easy to make a pitta bread. And I'm going to show you how. So I've got these two pieces of dough, and I just start off by making these into a nice little tight ball. Just like that. And take the first one. Now you want to come in close for this one and get a nice look. Just a tiny bit of flour on there. I don't want to sort of fold in lots and lots of flour if I can help it, but just a little bit. So I just sort of flatten that down a little bit, take the edge furthest away from me, and I fold that over into the middle of the dough, and I make a seam with my fingertips. I just lift that off, make sure that's not sticking to the table. Then I take the edge of the dough closest to me, I fold that over the top, and I press down that seam all the way along, tip the bread over, and flatten it down a little bit, and already that looks the right kind of a shape for a pitta bread. I'm going to let that one rest on there for a couple of minutes and do exactly the same with this one. So a little bit of flour, not terribly much. Flatten the bread down, fold it over into the middle, make a seam, fold the bottom right over the top, make the big seam, tip over, flatten it down. There's my pitta bread shape ready to go. And now I'm going to roll these out using plenty of flour so it doesn't stick to the table. Because we made a lovely strong elastic dough, it'll kind of fight against me a little bit. So I'll just roll them out and let them rest for a minute or two. Roll them out and let them rest for a minute or two. And if you're doing a dozen or so of these, it's very easy because you just kind of work your way along all the different breads. And then by the time you come back to the first one, that one's kind of relaxed and ready to be rolled again. But if you look closely, you'll see that if I roll it out now, because it's not very relaxed, it sort of springs back. And if I force it, what tends to happen then is the shape kind of distorts and you get thick bits and thin bits. And if you get thick bits and thin bits, it just doesn't puff open in the way that a pitta bread should. So I'm better off to let it relax and certainly not try and force it out. And because of the way I folded it up, what should happen is that as I roll it, this forms into exactly the right shape for a pitta bread. It may be that it just needs to be a little bit fatter, in which case I'll roll it that way. But pretty much if I just roll to and fro up and down the bread, I'll end up with the right shape. Since I'm just making two though, I'm going to roll those out to that point and I'm going to let them relax for a couple of minutes and then come back to them. So I've just given our pittas 2 or 3 minutes here to relax, and if we come in close, will see that as I roll this out now, it rolls out much more willingly than if I was trying to fight against all that elasticity. We're almost at the right kind of thickness. I need them to be 3 or 4 millimeters thick, no more than that. And I'm just using a sort of gentle pressure on these, not really forcing it. You can see this really sort of active dough is already getting nice and bubbly. One roll across just to widen it a little bit. And now we just need those to relax before they go in the oven. If they went straight in the oven now, then as soon as they get the heat hit them, they sort of go and shrink back completely. And we don't want that. So we're going to give those another few minutes to rest on the table, but not really, we're not going to really leave them to rise and puff up, because we want them to puff open and not puff up and be a light textured bread. So 4 or 5 minutes just to relax, and then they'll be ready for the oven. So our pittas have now had 4 or 5 minutes on the table, just resting and relaxing so they don't shrink back in the oven. I can pick them up quite happily, pop them onto my wooden peel, ready to slide them on the stone that I have nicely heated up in the oven. And the oven wants to be nice and hot for this, so that the breads puff open as quickly as possible. So just make sure that they're ready to go, or sliding nicely on the peel. So you'll see the stones I've got in the oven, and the pittas just slide straight off onto those. These are only going to take 3 or 4 minutes really, and we just want them to puff open. What we don't want to happen is for the for a crust to start forming and for the breads to start going crisp. So as soon as they're ready, out they'll come. We'll wrap them up in a nice clean cloth, and that'll keep them nice and soft. And what you should see after sort of about 45 seconds or a minute, you'll start to see the breads puffing, and then all of a sudden they puff right open. And once they've puffed open, I'll flip them over, and as soon as they start taking a little bit of colour, just a little bit of golden brownness, then that's them done. And I can just see them now around the edges starting to puff. Always a tense moment, never quite sure whether they're going to puff, or are we sure? Of course we're sure, we're always confident of these things. They're definitely going to puff, and you can see them now really filling up. And all of a sudden they go, great fun on our children's cooking classes, cooking these pita breads, because you know, their eyes are wide open. There's the one on the right, completely sort of puffing, up it goes. And there goes the one on the left as well. And they will just burst and collapse, because all the steam forces a big pocket, and then it'll find a little weak spot, and it'll puff, and it'll the steam will all escape. So I'm now just going to flip them over. Just being careful as I do that there's some very hot steam coming out of there, and just let them go again for another 30, 45 seconds. And that should be plenty. So they are going to come out. And if we have a look, you can just see a little bit of colour around the edges there. That's all we want is a little bit of colour. I mean, at that sort of 3 or 4 millimetre thickness that we put them in the oven at, you know, we know they're going to be cooked in just 4 or 5 minutes, so we don't need to wait any longer. And there are the pittas out of the oven. What I want to do with those is wrap them up. Then the steam, as they cool, the steam will keep them nice and soft. If I left them out in the open, they'd sort of crisp up. And then when we came to open them up into a pitta pocket, that wouldn't be quite so good. They'd be crispy and much more likely to break. So I'm going to set those to one side and let those cool. And then a little bit later on, fill them with some salad and some hummus and some tomatoes. Absolutely fantastic. Our pitta bread is now cold and ready for us to stuff and make a nice snack or a nice lunch. So here's one we made earlier. And hopefully, when we open this up, we'll have no trouble at all opening up the pocket. Certainly by the way they puffed up in the oven that we saw, there shouldn't be any trouble. And there we are, that opens up perfectly. And because we've kept them wrapped up, the steam just keeps them nice and moist, so they're nice and pliable, and we don't have to be too worried about them splitting. You know, they may split a little bit, that's not really a problem. So, what we have here, a little bit of salad, a little bit of lemon dressing on the salad, some chopped up tomatoes, and some slivers of red onion. And then this is homemade hummus with lemon and garlic. So a chickpea paste with lemon and garlic. And the recipe for this you can find on our website, mannafromdevon.com, and a video for this you'll find on this channel. So all I do, and pitta breads are fantastically versatile. You can stuff them with roasted lamb, barbecued lamb, grilled lamb would be absolutely classic. Grilled chicken, all sorts of things, fish, tagines, you name it, you can put it inside a pitta pocket. But a typical Middle Eastern recipe would certainly be some hummus and in a pitta pocket. So we put a little bit of hummus in there and spread it around. A little bit of our lettuce, pop that down in. Couple of bits of tomato and some red onion, and then just repeat that process. A little bit more of that, a little bit of the hummus so that we can see what's in it basically. A few more bits of tomato and finish it off with some onion, just like that. Lovely. There's one. And the next piece, exactly the same, hummus, salad, tomato, onion, salad, bit more hummus, a few more bits of tomato, finish it off with some onion and a couple of those chickpeas. And there's some lemon zest in there as well. And there we have homemade pitta, homemade hummus, just as a simple little snack, very nourishing, very nutritious, lovely and colourful, wonderfully fragrant. All the recipes can be found on the website, mannafromdevon.com. And we hope to see you back here sometime soon for some more recipes.